has it 6 PM today. We have two more confirmed cases. Both of these cases are of rail passengers who came in by one of the transit trains which passed via Goa yesterday. It's a couple, a husband and wife, who came in, and they have been confirmed positive after the RT-PCR confirmatory. So this brings our cases to 45. Today we sent 723 samples for testing. We got 736 results. 39 results are awaited. There are 6 patients who are in hospital isolation. Today we have home quarantined 269 people who came, domestic travelers, by road. And then facility quarantine, we have 379 people. A total of around 988 people are under quarantine, the 14-day quarantine which is going on. Out of this, 586 are seafarers and 204 are. I just want to clarify one thing, that there were a few media reports today that one of the air passengers who came in yesterday in the 3 flights from Italy was tested positive. It is true that that person's test was TrueNAT screening positive, but that person has been tested negative twice in our RT-PCR test at GMC. Therefore, there is actually no positive person in the 416 air passengers who came yesterday. So just a clarification. I also would like to clarify that one of our media friends yesterday had raised, I don't see her today, she had raised a point about some complaint regarding stamping and skin infection. I think that has also been reported in one of the papers. But the report itself says that the complaint was raised with the DC and SP of Karwar, that stamping has been done on the Karnataka side of the border. So it is again not a case of the stamp or the ink that we are using here. However, we are vigilant. If there is any further report, we will definitely look into it. But this particular case was definitely not on our side of the border. Yesterday, there was also a question regarding number of quarantine centers. So the number of quarantine centers are like this. There are 14 which are under government control. Government quarantine facilities, there are 14. And then there are 9 more private facilities. Now this number is increasing every day, meaning whichever category of travelers are coming who are under paid quarantine are selecting their own hotel. So this number is dynamic, it will keep increasing. So this was it. Today the board exams have happened smoothly. We had one paper of political science for the 12th standard students and one a pre-vocational paper for the 10th standard students. Both exams have happened smoothly. I think Goa Board Chairman must have mentioned to you that for the border students, we have made special arrangements across the border, 4 schools in Maharashtra, very close to our border, and 2 schools in Karnataka, very close to our border again, have been organized with the active cooperation and support of the district magistrates of these 2 bordering states. So they are not coming into Goa, they are attending the exams across the border.
Trains were planned. One train has already left with around 1600 passengers. It went from Karmali to Balia in UP. Another 2 trains will leave. One is going to Varanasi, again UP, and the last one, the one is going to Manipur, and we are also taking it to the Tripura passengers. It will have a halt at Madhya Pradesh, so it will pick some. Tomorrow we have planned to send many more trains, about 6 to UP, and that will take a very substantial number of standard UP people, and that will reduce our effort to a little bit. Thereafter, on the action taken, I just want to confirm that there are on speeding cases, 113 more cases have been booked, and on mass chalan, 542 more cases have been booked. So total number has reached to 52,364. All kind of actions taken during the lockdown, and this is all from my.
How many people are going by these trains? बड़बड़ी का पता है 1000
यस फॉर अदर ट्रेन्स दे आर बीइंग सिलेक्टेड दे आर फिलिंग द ट्रेन सो अंटिल अनलेस द ट्रेन लीव वी कांट गिव यू द कंफर्म नंबर दैट हाउ मेनी पैसेंजर्स आर विल बी गोइंग दैट
मैम टू पैसेंजर्स हैव टेस्टेड पॉजिटिव व्हिच ट्रेन वाज दैट
दिस वाज अ ट्रेन व्हिच वाज गोइंग टू द ट्रेन व्हिच केम फ्रॉम दिल्ली These two passengers, by the way, are from Mumbai. They boarded the train from Mumbai. But that was a transit train which originated in Delhi, did not terminate here.
But were they Goans?
Well, they do have a local address here in Goa. So that is the information that I have as of now.
Ma'am, could you highlight on this? You said that seat was positive, then negative.
What more information would you like to
know? Well, firstly, he tested positive.
Yes.
Then again,
he did not test. The TrueNAT screening test, which I've explained in detail yesterday, I don't want to get into that again. The TrueNAT screening test, he was a borderline case. He tested positive, borderline. So naturally, as I explained yesterday, we have to run the test again on RT-PCR for confirmation. Negative. We again did the test today. That test is again negative. So two times we have confirmed he is negative. Therefore, none of those 416 passengers who came yesterday are positive.
Madam, are you all going to treat him as a separate case in quarantine?
Not exactly. You see, anyways, all the air passengers are under 14-day institutional quarantine. So we are shifting him back to the institutional quarantine. We had brought him out because we wanted to take the swab, etc. He'll be sent back to the hotel where all of them are. They are split into 3-4 hotels because it's a huge number. He'll be going back to the hotel where he was.
Madam,
no?
I have a question.
Few locals are opposing the quarantine.
Just a moment, please. Yes.
I just want to know how many tests has been conducted in a private lab, which has been approved by the government, and whether that reports are been reflected in this bulletin or not.
Those test results, what the number of tests done, are not reported in our bulletin, but every time there is a positive case, it is highlighted to us. Let me use this opportunity, since you have raised that point, that SRL Diagnostics was given the permission by ICMR to conduct tests. Their lab is in Mumbai. One of the labs which they got approval for, they are a national chain. One of those labs was in Mumbai. So once they got approval, they approached us, the DHS, to ask for permission to do swab collection here in Goa. Based on ICMR approval, we had given permission for swab collection. We have had three results which have come from SRL, which we are actually adding in our active cases even now. Out of these 45, three are such. You must be recollecting industry workers, farmer workers who are coming across the border. They were getting their tests done through SRL. Now, these three cases which SRL has diagnosed as positive, we have diagnosed as negative. We have repeatedly done the test. So today we have actually officially decided, the file has been approved, that the permission that we gave to SRL to collect swabs here in Goa, we are temporarily withholding.
Okay.
Yes.
My second question is, yesterday one incident happened in South Goa. There are some workers who are Goan, mainly Goan, but they had, during lockdown, they were been in Karnataka. So they came yesterday, they entered, so they have been directly taken into quarantine. For 3 days, their swab has not been taken. So they were just asking, because as immediately when they come, their swab has been taken. No? So they were asking when their swab will be taken. Then the particular people have came and they told that if you want immediate result, you have to pay 4,200 rupees. So they paid 4,200 rupees, but they have not been given receipts.
You're talking about the private lab? Because 4,200 can only be a private lab.
They don't know anything about which lab and nothing.
Were they brought in by GSIA or pharma industry? Association?
I think so.
Yes, then this question should be asked to
company
yes, yes. So then this question should be asked to the Pharma Industry Association or GSI.
No, but if
yes.
they are not taking these cases seriously, if at all they were brought, they were kept in a hotel for 3 days, for which they are paying from their pocket, and their swab is taken after 3 days. So this is lethargy on part of even that company, because that swab has to be taken immediately, no?
Please share this feedback to the association and the pharma industry, because this is not something that health department is controlling at all.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
And I already told you that we have suspended their, we have suspended their permission to collect swabs.
Okay.
Now, whoever comes, if at all they come, we will be testing through our own protocol.
Okay.
Thirdly,
sir, I just want my, now that migrants are going in their native places,
then since you have arranged railways for that, they have to pay something to go to their native places, or they are taken without any charge?
No, state governments are paying. Their home state governments are paying for their travel charges. They are depositing the money directly to the Indian Railway, and based on that, we are based on the payment made, we are releasing the trains. We are sharing the list of these migrants to the their native states. Once they clear it, then the trains are leaving.
So now, what is the exact figure? How many migrants have been registered to go to their native place, and how many has already gone?
Yesterday I gave the numbers. I'll again share that on our portal about 1.25 lakh people have registered. Out of them, till now 132 people have left.
Okay.
You can include this 1600 now, because the train has left. That number is not reflected here. And incoming is 3914. It is since 29th April 2020 and till 3 p.m. today.
Now, since the air service has been resumed from 25 onwards, what exact arrangement government has done to facilitate those people who will be coming in Goa?
As far as once these domestic flights starts, we have to see that how many and how the arrangement is being done. Ministry has issued a detailed guidelines. We are going through it, we are examining it, and based on that guidelines, we will be preparing our response and our strategy to handle the incoming passengers.
But they have to intimate state government before they come here, or?
No, there is a provision that the list will be shared with the state governments.
Okay.
Based on that, we will be making our response.
But they will be tested at the airport again?
See, those guidelines have just been issued. Just about a couple of hours back, as Secretary Revenue has already mentioned, that is under examination.
Yesterday there was a huge commotion in Kandore regarding the quarantine hotel, wherein the locals opposed seafarers being kept in the residential area. Their main complaint was they were not informed, or the panchayat or police were not told about anything. Do you have any information about it? What has the administration done?
I don't know about this particular instance in Kandore.
These seafarers have been tested negative.
Yeah.
They none of them have any infection, and their company has booked these hotels. They are private institution. We are facilitating. We have declared them as COVID quarantine centers for us. That's all we can share.
One more thing I will bring to your notice. If you go to the private websites, Make My Trip and Go, IBGO and all, they are all taking hotel bookings right from today. Right from today, the online bookings of hotels are on. I don't know what is the thing. Are people coming from outside for these bookings?
As per MHA guidelines, there you must have gone through those guidelines. There are very specific categories for which. So whatever is as per the guidelines is admissible. Whatever is not as per guidelines is not admissible. Even in the revised guidelines for lockdown 4.0, it is mentioned here. Yes.
As of today, all 45 active cases are imported from outside.
That's right.
So now domestic flights are going to start, and interstate railways services will also be resumed. So any decision has been taken by the government, because all are imported cases, not to allow, because center also said that it should be in concern with the state government. State government can will have their say.
Already we have explained that those guidelines have just come, at least as far as air passengers are concerned. It is under examination of government.
How long it will take?
The natural time which is taken for examination in such a crisis situation.
One more question. I don't know, you must have located in Margao near railway station. There are number of laborers who are sitting across the roads. So what is the issue you have? Anybody has read to your notice about that? Why they are sitting, and what is the issue about that?
Based on the registration done on our portal, we issue SMSs to these people that okay, you can come, and whenever the train is planned, the train like in UP, they have been planned district wise.
So many of them may be coming just because their friend may have got the message, or the extra person may be coming. Otherwise, at wherever I visited, I seen the facilities which district has made. They have been kept in different groups in tents, provided sitting facility, and all arrangements have been done. But there may be some anxiety in some people, and they may be coming in advance.
These laborers are sitting along the roads.
No, that's what I'm saying, that may be coming, but with we hope that after tomorrow's large movement of these people, we hope that this situation will improve.
They are also in large number of crowds, so precautions have been taken.
Yeah, that was one of the reasons, because of the stone pelting which happened on Sunday.
Yeah,
on police.
No, that's what I'm saying, that tomorrow, if really, when we are attempting a the largest departure of train from Goa as of yet through the our management, that we are doing it with district teams. But we are taking special cares that we are sending messages only to limited number of people. We have segregated the trains district-wise so that we can focus that only the people of the nearby district are sent to that particular destination.
It appears that these people, these laborers, I think they have not registered on portal. It appears because
wherever we got the information, we are registering, calling them, and we are registering people. And we are taking, if someone is in extra, we are taking them to the nearest shelter homes. You may be seeing that people are sitting, but there are people who are being continuously shifted to shelter homes. We are providing food and we are making necessary arrangements. And as I said, I hope that tomorrow situation will improve drastically.
My question is to the health secretary. Ma'am, I hear some whispers from from lower medical staff in the COVID hospital. They are facing problems of not being distributed safety equipment and stuff like that, especially in the COVID hospital. We had this problem also in senior residents almost went on a no work strike kind of a thing in the last week of April. What exactly is the problem? Are we facing a shortage of safety equipment?
Though I should not be responding to whispers, but since the question that you raised is a very important question, let me reassure you that we have no shortage of personal protective equipment. We have maintained a very comfortable stock right from the beginning. Government of India has been supporting our efforts by giving us allotment. Yesterday we were allotted 5,000 PPEs. On the 13th of May we were allotted 5,000, which are on its way. In fact, I believe they have been delivered yesterday. Yes, today I was getting the confirmation from my team. Another 5,000 have already been permitted by Government of India. We are procuring at our own end. There is absolutely no shortage for PPEs. I have personally spoken to the in-charge doctors at COVID hospital and assured them that whatever they require, without any questions asked, whatever the COVID hospital requires will be given to them. And this is the instruction to everybody in the health department. Regarding GMC, there may have been issues, but again, there was never a situation where we had any shortage of PPEs. We have always maintained a very comfortable
situation. No, I think GMC faces a problem of the supply chain within the hospital, because now GMC has outsourced that internal pharmacy thing to a private player. So that protocol and that process,
but that has
indentation
not... mm-hmm.
and getting the material
mm-hmm.
on the ground zero to the particular people who need it,
yes,
is not smoothly flowing. I think that is the problem.
You would recollect probably that the Honorable Health Minister and myself had gone to GMC. We had had a very detailed meeting and we had given our feedback to the Dean GMC that there should be absolutely no shortage. In fact, there should be no grievances whatsoever. Having said this, there is a protocol. There is a protocol which has been defined by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare for the various levels. It's a gradation. You can't have full PPE for every single person in GMC. It has to be graded. It has to be a graded response. But again, this is nothing ambiguous. It's a very clearly laid down guideline by the ministry. We are following the ministry's guidelines plus two more steps, I would say, to ensure that our people are satisfied and that there are no problems and they have no concern about their safety. This is our primary responsibility.
The exams began yesterday and today. So has there been any case of a student who has shown symptoms, and what is the protocol to deal with it?
Yesterday Chairman Goa Board and Secretary may have explained, but since you ask me, I'll just repeat the protocol. what the Ministry of Home Affairs has stipulated in their exemption to Goa government, which by the way they have expanded to all states. They have issued a general guideline as well, a general permission saying that exams can be exempted based on the conditions. The conditions are the following. There should be a thermal screening of the students who are entering the examination center and appearing for the exam. There should be sanitizers kept at the entry points. The students, staff, everybody in the exam conducting team should be wearing masks. And there should be social distancing maintained within the classroom.
No, I'm asking if there is a student with symptoms.
Right. Yeah. If now symptoms, by symptoms what we mean is that student shows high temperature during the thermal screening. What we have decided is if there is such a situation, so far we have not got that situation. If there is such a situation, we will isolate the student in a completely different room. We will give one room to that student alone. All our examination centers have enough rooms. We have ensured that we have the facility for that. So we will not allow that student to give the exam along with other students. At the same time, we cannot deny that student the opportunity to appear for the exam. We will isolate the student, put him or her in a separate classroom, and with all due precautions, we will allow the student to take the exam.
Yeah, regarding this SCC and HCCC examination, government was very strict with the decision to conduct exams, and even central government has given an exemption, by giving exemptions to Goa, they also given exemptions to all the states. Now, considering this situation, what is the reason why Goa University has postponed their exams to July? Because their exams were from 1st June. They have cancelled first year, second year's exam, and they have postponed the third year exam from 1st July. What is the exact reason? If SEC exams can be conducted, why Goa University cannot conduct exams?
Based on my discussions with Goa University, the logic is the same. Why have we cancelled the other exams and gone ahead with 10th and 12th? Because we know that these are two decisive years which decide the academic career of the students. Same is the logic of deciding not to go ahead with the first and second year exams, but not compromising on their academic careers by having the third year exams. The dates were accordingly redecided because the exam dates included first, second and third year. Because first and second year was not going to be held after their new decision, they may have decided to reschedule the dates for third year. Yeah, the logic is the same. The principle is the same.
No, the logic is the same, but all preparation was there. Every college has done their preparation to conduct exam from 1st June. But if they are really serious about the safety of the student, then this logic should be also...
No, I'm sure Goa University will take all necessary measures for ensuring the safety of the students,
because
even when they have...
1st July, that month of July in Goa, during monsoon, is a very critical month. So in that month, if they are totally going ahead with sparing the month of June and they are taking exam in 1st July, then that month have severe rains in Goa. No?
You see, I don't think we can put the category of school students with the category of college students, and that to third year students. That's all that I would to say about this. The rest is, of course, the decision of Goa University. They are university, they are free to decide.
College students will be highly immune, no? And these college students are highly immune because they are just graduate, but SEC students, they are small children. If they can give exams in this scenario, then third year students can be easily given the exams.
I would not like to comment any further on this. I have shared with you my discussions with Goa University. The rest is a decision of the university as they deem fit.
Teams of doctors are increased at COVID hospital. Teams are.
What we have done is we have told GMC and Dean has issued orders for consultants. Because you see, we may have specific cases of somebody with certain specific medical conditions, specific medical history. So the consultants of Goa Medical College, like I mentioned yesterday, are also very much part of the COVID team of doctors.
Enough strength is there.
Absolutely.
Madam, I wanted one information. This is a little more. We had conducted community health survey. Na? Some
that's
5,000
right.
odd were identified with different
yes.
ailments.
Yes.
What happened to that later on?
We have done the testing for those who were voluntarily willing to give their samples. There were certain individuals who said, we don't want to give our samples. So naturally, we have not forced them to give the samples. Rest everybody who cooperated with us and gave their samples, we have been testing them.
How many?
Numbers I don't have as of now. I can check and let you know.
Can you share a light on this protocol that has been adopted at borders for our vehicle drivers, including essential and non-essential drivers, the services drivers? But as of my information, there was only screening in thermal. Has government taken any decision or any protocol has been finalized for their testing? Because there are districts nearby.
across the border with some more cases. So what is the procedure?
MHA's guidelines are extremely clear about this, that there is no distinction between essential and non-essential goods and commodities. All goods vehicles have to be given a seamless movement. This we have been following and we are abiding by the MHA guideline.
What about a testing?
So if you want to have seamless movement, naturally you can only have the screening. The moment you stop somebody, take their swab, ask them to wait till testing, it is not seamless. MHA's guidelines are very, very clear. There have been repeated directives from the Home Secretary to the state governments all over the country that there must be seamless movement.
Because all cases are imported cases. So in that regard, any government discuss on this?
The government's decision is to abide by the MHA's laid down guidelines regarding this.
Ma'am, you spoke about 45 cases at the moment. How is the condition of the earlier ones which the cases were found?
You mean the very first? Or
yeah,
the
very, very first, seven.
Earlier seven.
The family.
Four, seven, and
huh? Please don't name the patients.
Earlier,
maintain
seven.
Their confidentiality. You're talking about the first seven.
Yeah, first seven.
They are all doing very well. By the grace of God, they are all doing very well. They are all they have all completed their full quarantine period and much more than that, in fact.
Okay.
So they are all fine. They're doing
recovery
fine.
Recovery position?
Sorry?
Recovery soon?
Recovery, you mean those seven patients?
Yeah.
No,
it is only after they recovered that we allow them to.
Madam, after they get cured, is there a possibility of they
that's
get
what?
Getting the
relapse? You see, there are certain cases of a reinfection. It is
correct.
Technically called reinfection, having happened in some other countries, South Korea, etc. To the best of my knowledge, there has been no case of reinfection in India. To the best of my knowledge. Goa, I can definitely with 100% certainty tell you. All doing extremely fine as far as their health parameters are.
I also wanted to know one more clarification. People, sometimes you shift them in Sari ward, they have one more ward. And where the patients, whenever death occur, why they are covered in plastic bodies and handed over to families?
Why they're covered in plastic bodies?
Plastic
you see, I'm not a doctor and therefore I will not be in a position to reply your question. I can only hazard a guess that it might be an abundant precaution because you see, every Sari patient, every patient who is admitted to 113 and 115 wards of GMC are tested for COVID. You must be aware of that. So definitely perhaps as a safety protocol, as per their SOP, there must have been some decision by the department. I'm personally not aware of
any health guidelines have been sent to this transport department because we have seen a number of buses who have got this local passengers all crowded inside. There is no social distancing, nothing is maintained.
SCC has,
KTC or anybody.
SCC has maintained the decision that any transport which is permitted should be as per MHA guidelines. So the guidelines for transport of passengers is also laid down in MHA guidelines. That has to be followed.
But they are not following it, ma'am.
Yeah.
I
because we have seen number of buses.
Can
we just finish this?
We have seen the number of buses in the same every day. It has been happening in the past few days.
They are cleaning. They are doing special cleaning. They are doing hygienic. Today also the MDKTCL informed that they are taking mass drive to clean all the bus stops and everything. They are taking. The fire department was involved to even disinfect all the public places, even the bus. They are doing the regular cleaning and everything regarding the number of passengers, etc. We'll have a watch on this.
No, I'm not talking about the overcrowding of the buses.
No, that's why I said.
No, what you mean to say? They are not
following
50% sitting.
No, as that was in the previous lockdown measure, that 50% was as per the previous one. You checked in the new guidelines, there is no such a stipulation of 50%.
So they can be covered inside.
In regard to sanitization of buses, how government is ensuring private buses are being sanitized? Any mechanism is there by transport department?
Not compulsory.
Yes, this KTC is doing.
Regarding the protocol in the private buses, I'll get back. Tomorrow
social distancing.
Do you care
about social distancing? Yes.
In front of the secretaries, we are not going
to.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you.